I'm sitting here today, folks, with Jason Brown of Love Hot Dog Company and the Lemonade Brothers. Y'all have heard him live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio for over a year now. And he is helps and gives advice and shares, and he vends full time. He's got a concession trailer. He's got ice cream bikes or trikes, however you want to say it. And that's what I wanted to interview Jason about today, is about these ice cream bikes and trikes, so that we could share this. It's pretty neat. I've actually done it. I did it for 2 summers so that I could get an idea of, you know, the kind of money, the averages you could make. But, and I think you've got one there behind you. In fact, I'm positive it is.
Yeah, there's one sitting back there.
And it's got a piano attached to it, so you can ride and play.
Yes, that's the entertained model.
Now, these are some of your prototype stuff, and it's a three-wheeled bike that you pedal. Yeah. And then it has a mechanical refrigerator or freezer, fridge freezer.
It's a freezer that runs as a fridge too.
Okay, so it can run either way, but it has a double door type deal. You open the top and it's still closed and sealed with glass sliding doors, right?
Yes. Yeah. When you open the top lid there on the freezer behind me, you lift the big lid up. There are horizontal doors that slide back and forth. This way, we're never actually opening the whole freezer to the heat.
Right.
We're only ever opening half of it to reach in and grab something, and then you can slide the door shut again. So just trying to maximize on keeping everything cold.
Now, that's smart. Now, the gist is you ride around and you make money. But as with anything, there's pros and cons to it. And I'd like to go through some of that so that people can find out. And I know you've got a lot more answers and stuff and pictures on your website, but I wanted people to be exposed to it, to hear you in person, see you, and go, okay, now I know what I'm getting out of this as far as how this all works. Now you've got them in some of your prototypes have solar power and just battery operated. So you could go either way.
Yes.
The benefits, or I'll tell you what, let's start with the negatives to a business. And as you know, with any business, there's negatives. Negatives are any red tape that you would have be required for state, your local municipalities, whatever they are, to get approved and operational. The next one would be that it's still work. Although you can make money, it still work, and there's the potential you will miss, you know, reruns of Love Boat or Jerry Springer. And I think even Jerry Springer's, you know, his old Bouncer has a show now.
Oh yeah.
I don't know what it's called, but somebody told me about it. Yeah. But anyway, he's got a show that, you know, they will find out who the daddy is kind of shows. So, I saw a YouTube clip somebody sent me. I think it was Rob McDowell. He sent me a clip. He's a vendor, and it said it was a clip of one of these shows, and it had 4 men on the screen, and they were all going, you know, they're probably the dad. They're all there to find out who the dad is, and they all tested negative.
Whoops.
Turns out it was Immaculate Conception. So, either way, what I wanted to do is let them know that yes, there are some stuff. You have maintenance. You have the fact that you have to be responsible enough to run a business, do profit and loss, figure out that type of stuff. There's some handy tools and tricks, like you talk about SalesView. There's some tricks for making this easier, your life easier. You could get QuickBooks. You could use a yellow pad like I do. And I write down my stuff daily. And then my wife will put that now into the software. Now, just the other day, I talked about this on the show. I downloaded SalesView so I can keep up my records. But the bottom line is we have to keep our records so you know you're profitable or not. What are some of the other cons that you know of, Jason, as far as the negatives to this or any type of business?
Well, the first one would probably be that it's seasonal. I mean, obviously, area to area, you know, people down south or out west might have a longer season than we do here in Pennsylvania.
Right.
Here, we're probably about 6 months. But there are vendors, you know, you can make enough in 6 months and not have to work the rest of the year or do other things, you know, other projects and things.
Right.
The next thing would be, you know, you're outside. You know, we're not sitting in a comfy office in a cube or, you know, somewhere like that. You're going to be outside in the elements. So, you know, it's going to be sunny. You know, there's going to be bees, things like that, but, you know, it is what it is. I mean, still beats being stuck inside a cube.
Right. Well, it beats a lot of other things that have more risk. And okay. That's where I want to go with the pros of this business. There are a lot of pros that negate many other vendor-related type businesses, but a lot of other businesses in general. You don't need a college degree. Nope. You don't need to have a lot of money to get started.
You can actually do a zero-down lease. I mean,
right. You can do a zero-down lease. You could do and now, you know, with that new lease company, you can do a zero-down lease even with D credit. You can have D credit and have no money down, make your first payment, and you're good to go. Or make your first and last payment. I know they do some of that too. But
I think when it's really bad, I think they do first and last. I think it depends on your credit. But, I mean, still, it, you know, very affordable payments.
Right. You get started in a business with something like this, and from day one, you can be making money. And even if you have a bad day, you have no waste. Yeah. There's never any waste.
Not like the food vending business where we have waste.
Yeah.
You know, it's prepackaged, it's all frozen. And, you know, I mean, there's a couple of different ways you could run when you get home. You can leave everything inside the freezer and just plug it in to top off your batteries and run through the night. Or, you know, have yourself a freezer at home, whether it be an upright or a chest freezer, if you're going to keep some extra. And, you know, a couple different ways to go there. But, I mean, it's still a lot easier. No cleanup, no scrubbing pans, no burn on food. You know, a lot easier.
Now, I know that a lot of states are saying that you don't have to have a commissary. Some states don't require commissary for this or hand-washing sinks because you are serving something that is factory-packaged, individually wrapped, frozen, so it's a non-potentially hazardous product, and you're handing it out. And so it's immediate cash. And if you have a bad day, it starts raining, you need to go home and you have $200 worth of product inside, you can throw it back in the freezer or leave it there, plug it in, whatever you want to do. You've lost nothing.
Yep.
And you got a day to catch up on Jerry Springer reruns. So it's a win-win. In my case, I put my son and daughter on the cart, and I want to bring this point up because it's important, but I put them on the carts because I wanted to see how well it did. We did it for 2 summers straight, and I wanted to make sure that it was a viable business and that it could really work, and how much money can you make? Obviously, going from a little town to a big town, and depending on your restrictions with rules and states and all that stuff, which obviously, by the way, you have less codes to comply to, period. Yeah. But, and you can get started almost immediately. I got mine approved the same day. It was just bam, bam. I filled out it's 2 sheets of paper. One had some rules and stuff and when I was supposed to report, you know, renew the license. But other than that, it was pretty simple. They inspected it just to make sure that it would reach the temperature. And that was it. But I put them on it, but I want to, this is maybe covered in one of the cons. One of the negatives about this type of business is you men typically aren't as approachable on these. Young, you know, boys, teenagers, girls, teenagers are fine, even adult women, but men are not. But there's a loophole. And the loophole is dressing up, maybe like a milkman. Nothing, you know, not a clown outfit, not some, you know, Star Wars character, but something so that you're more approachable. If you have a bow tie, suspenders, white shirt, white pants, you look like the old milkman, okay? And the only people that would be hesitant there is the men that work out of town and leave their wives at home. And so, I told my daughter, I aggravated her all the time that she was a product of a milkman. So that would be the only thing, but by far the daily income with having somebody else run this, especially if they're, you know, a teen or even females all the way up, you know, they can be adults, they're going to make really good money. We were averaging 4 plus with, this is daily, in sales from ice cream. And it wasn't an all day. It wasn't 9 hours of grind and pedaling. But let's talk about another one of the pros to this, Jason, is the going green.
Oh, yeah.
How big is that right now?
Well, that's a huge thing right now. You know, buzzword or just, you know, thing that's front and central now. Anything that's green and renewable. So, you know, one, we're using the sun to freeze the ice cream. Two, we're using human power to pedal it around or move the business. So you've got two green things moving this business. I mean,
right.
The news coverage, whether it be paper or electronic news gathering, the potential there is huge to get the business started fast. There's nobody else doing this. There's no ice cream bike or ice cream truck that's solar powered and human powered. So you should be able to call your local news, your newspaper, and just get huge traction to get your business just catapulted right away.
Is there something you could offer, let's say, for customers so that they could download a PDF that's kind of a press release, just a generic press release, where they fill in the blank on their company name and whatever they're going to name it, but they could send that to the local stations, the radio, the Chamber of Commerce, any Go Green organizations in their area or even in their state?
Yeah.
I've heard there's potential state funding for green companies.
Oh, yeah. There's tax breaks and different things. I mean, you know, each state and county and things like that's a little different. But, yeah, I mean, I would look into any of that for funding, grants, anything like that. You know, I mean, right now it's just a huge plus being green and being renewable.
Right. Well, So we've got several benefits to this. Low cost initial startup, very little risk, because the worst case is you decide you don't like this business, you're going to eat some great ice cream. But there, little waste, output for inventory is limited. You can buy it daily depending on how close your supplier is. Novelty ice creams, Sam's Club sells them. But if you go through one of the food distributors in your area, you can buy this. You know, some of the food distributors deliver 3 times a week and you can buy just what you need every week. Some food distributors let you go to their door and pick up what you need. So if you ran out of Dreamsicles, you go pick them up.
Yep.
So very little waste.
That's a good advantage, because you can start out by, even if you're picking up every day, and after a few days of sales, start putting a little bit aside to buy an extra box of Dreamsicles or an extra box of, the Dove bars or things. And then yourself a freezer at home and have a backup, you know, because it might be closer going home than it is going to your distributor.
Now, something we haven't talked about yet and is the potential for renting these to organizations for branding.
Okay. Branding, fundraising, party planners, wedding planners, car dealerships, I mean, birthday parties. There's just a huge market for putting these out there.
And you could dress these up however you wanted. You could put logos and stuff on the side. I know ours had drop-in plexiglass, and we could change the sheet behind it to ice cream, to whatever. We did 2 days of just water during an event, a festival, and we went through somewhere in the neighborhood of 30 cases of water in 1 day.
Yep. Well, that's the other good thing about the freezer is, you know, let's say you get yourself a second cart or, you know, you might want to just do drinks at an event. You can run it as a refrigerator or a freezer. So you got some versatility there. And again, it's still green, still refrigerating the water via the sun. So you still got your green aspect. But the rental side of it is just unlimited. Same thing with branding. I mean, using a green product to get your name out there. I mean, you could go to your sign shop and have tins made up and holes punched in them and just zip tie them to the side of the frame and put Ben's carts on there, or put Ford on it, and, you know, drinks provided by or ice cream provided by, and brand the sides of it, the front of it and the other side. So, you know, and you can do that, and you pass that to pass through, you know, you pass that cost right on to whoever you're working for.
Well, you've got so many potentials. So you could run it yourself. You could hire people to run it. You could lease them out for them to run. You could do profit sharing with it, or you could even do this, the sponsored stuff.
Yeah.
So you've got multiple avenues, much easier to get started. Let's talk about the money that you can make and how that breaks down. Because, you know, a lot of people don't know what a novelty ice cream costs other than retail. They go into the gas station and they see the Mickey Mouse bar with the chocolate ears and you go $3 or $2.50. And what you actually pay, and I know this because I did this for two summers, is about 30 cent to 80 cent, depending on the quality of the novelty bar. So if it's a Dove bar or the Magnum chocolate bars with the real caramel infused into it with the almond toffee crunch, well, yeah, you'll pay 80 cent for those a piece. It's a $3 bar or $4 bar all day long.
Oh, God, yeah. Well, like my cheesecake on a stick. You know, we sell that Wonder Bar. I mean, that runs about $1.20. And at my everyday stand location, we're charging $4.25 for that. If we go to an event, that's a $5.50 item. And we sell them. I mean, the average markup on novelties is some of the more expensive stuff. You know, if you go with their suggested retail, which I think is a little bit low, you're at 65%, but I'd say the average is probably 85% markup.
What is that, the cheesecake bar cost you per each?
Right now they cost me, it's like $1.18 or $1.19.
Well, see, that's the most expensive ones I've seen. Even that Magnum bar, the big Magnum bars that my wife loves them, they're 80 cent in bulk. You know, when I buy a case of them, and a case may be, and I'm not positive on this, but I think a case is 36 or 42 or 48. It's a small box of Magnum.
That's the other good thing about the novelties. It's, you know, the cases are small, 12, 36, you know, it's smaller. So it's not like buying other items for vending. It's smaller, but yeah, that's an expensive item, but I have to bring those in from Chicago. They have to get trucked in, and, you know, so that brings the cost up. That's not something I get through my local novelty supplier. Everything else, like the Dove bars, Mickey Mouse, SpongeBob, that kind of stuff, I can get locally from my guy. And the other thing, you know, to think about for home, if you start the business right away and you're moving, I can't promise you this, but most of the vendors, if you're buying the novelty from them, will give you a freezer for home. You can get a small chest freezer from them just for buying the product from them.
And they'll give you all the decals you can stand.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Anything.
From the chocolate cake, the shortcake.
Oh, yeah.
My best sellers was the shortcake, the chocolate and strawberry shortcake bars, the SpongeBob ice cream with the gumballs for the eyes, and the what is the rocket ship? It's an ice bar. It's not even ice cream. It's just ice.
Yeah, the red, white, and blue rocket.
Red, white, and blue rocket.
Rocket pop, yeah.
Yep. And we did pretty well. We went to an event where we were asked to come, and we had a ton. I had bought at Sam's of those boxes. I think it's 160 a box, 160 pieces, but it's a, it's just that plastic Kool-Aid.
The push-up popsicle.
Yeah, it's just a push-up.
Snip the top, yep.
Snip the top and go to town. And they cost you less than a quarter a piece. I think it was like 7 cents or something ridiculous.
Yep.
And we were selling those for $1.
Oh, yeah.
And now we did some on the cart on normal days for 50 cent, but $1 didn't change anything. We didn't sell less when we went to $1.
Yeah.
So to give you an idea, let's say you're averaging, $2, let's say $1 a bar. If you sold 100 a day, okay, if you just caught kids coming out of school every day or drove through a neighborhood every day riding your bike or just the around the park every day, you're talking $100. $2 profit per each one, you're making $200. And you're not talking about all day. You're talking you can catch 100 kids at the park in a period of an hour. And you can go back 3 hours later and it's a whole new batch of kids.
Yeah.
So
I mean, the other thing are like the inner city neighborhoods, where, you know, in the towns where you can actually ride through town and almost develop a route, just like the ice cream man.
And they expect you to come.
The key there is you're going to have to be doing it every day, same time, and find out the good times. Find out at the factory, what time's the break? What time's everybody coming out for break?
Now, I put a music box on mine, just like at a PA system, just like the ice cream trucks do. And it powered off the same battery. And it uses very little power, but I could play the ice cream music, and there's like five different songs that are typical for ice cream, but then it also had sirens and stuff, but I think it had a total of 60 different sounds. It would do animal noises, but you're talking something that it was recognizable when you play that ice cream music. People turn and look. And
they know what it is.
And even if you don't have an ice cream truck in your town, it's even better because you'll gain a huge crowd. We didn't have an ice cream truck. I'm still not. And so if you pull this out today, my son could go out right now and make $400 and in a few hours he'd be done. He got to where he's 16 now. This was 2 years ago when he first did it. He would come back home and leave his sister out there on hers, and he would come back home, play Xbox and stuff, and then go back out, and he still wasn't losing any money. You know, she would get off the bike at the park, talk with friends, get back on the bike, and sell some more. He just came home, played the Xbox, and went back out.
Hey, nothing wrong with that.
Yeah. Right?
The nice thing is it's mostly cash. You can decide if you want to take credit cards, whether you use Square or SalesView like we talked about. So, you know, it's an easy business. It's easy to get into. It's easy to run. You know, buying the stuff, whether it be every day or once a week or every other week, checking into your distributor to get a freezer for home eventually is a nice thing to have a backup for those busier days. Or if you're going to know you're going to do a parade this weekend, you know, having a place that you can send, you know, your wife back, hey, get me 2 boxes of this and 3 of that and come back.
Right.
You know, that's a nice option. I mean, all the way around, I mean, it's an easy business to get into.
What is, to run. Let's talk about the cost a little bit. And I know you've got some prototypes available now that yes. you can have shipped out. There's things you've changed and upgraded. So they'd be getting a better price to take one that, you know, maybe needed to have been extended 3 inches longer or needed a bigger battery box, but they can do that themselves even if they wanted, or you can do it for them and charge them. But you've got some prototypes for sale, but you also have some new bikes coming in that are completely different than these behind you. I mean, you've changed some, the colors, obviously, the silver, orange, and what?
Blue.
That
will be the first production around those 3 colors.
And they can see those at IceCreamBike.biz.
I haven't put any pictures of the colors up except for silver.
Okay. Well, they can see the new design.
The new bike, yeah.
Okay.
We made some changes. Went to a bigger freezer. So you're now at a 5.3 cubic foot freezer. A little bit bigger solar panel. Changed up the frame, the battery location. Brakes, handlebars have been changed. Now on the front of the bike, we also put almost like a bumper around the front. So this way somebody that might have to tow to a location, whether they go to like a Lowe's or Home Depot and get one of the small garden trailers with the fold down ramp.
Right. $200, $300.
Yep. They can put the bike up on that trailer and now there's some tie down points and things.
Right.
So just trying to make it so that we're thinking about, you know, all the possibilities. You know, here, you know, we'd have to tow down to town, you know, because where we live, I would want the boys riding down that main road. So obviously we're going to put on a trailer. We needed some tie downs, things like that. But we made some good changes.
Good. So on these right now, you've got those coming. They can pre-order.
Yes. Pre-order.
And on that pre-order, they're going to get a discount.
Yes.
So roughly $600-$700, you told me? $500-$600, somewhere in there?
Yeah, it's going to be about $600.
$600 by pre-ordering?
Yes.
Okay.
And it also holds you one because, you know, it takes us some time to build.
Okay.
And, you know, this way you're in line and, you know, you're guaranteed where, you know, it could wind up being 2 months.
So you're ready now to take orders. You're ready to go. They're going to get a benefit, save some money by about $600 by pre-ordering and be first in line, don't have to keep waiting.
Yeah. And they've got the option of the no money down lease too. So, you know,
I like
good,
that.
Pretty good setup for them.
All right. And so, timeline you're looking at right now, you think, that May or end of May, June, you'll have these new production models available. And that's why you're doing the pre-orders so that you kind of know you can judge how much materials to have and all that stuff.
Yeah, just trying to get a feel. We've got some inquiries, got some people working through the lease company and things. So,
okay.
If we get pre-orders, it'll make it easy to guarantee your spot and timeline. Hopefully we get to the point that we can have some stock sitting, but right now it's just not working out that way. Things are going quick.
Right. Well, I'm glad that you came on so that people could learn about this, so they could see what the potential was. I've been asked a lot since we started talking about this on the radio show, and I guess you'll be on the radio show again today.
Yeah.
But
one other thing. I mean, even for our vendors that are already on a cart or a trailer, this is a perfect add-on, because you could technically have this sitting with your cart or your trailer or your truck every day, like we're doing, and it's an impulse buy for your current business, but also to let people know, hey, Ben, we're available for your son's party. Hey, Ben, we're available for your daughter's wedding reception, or, you know, your new car dealership opening, or your new store, or that fundraiser at your kid's school. So it's just a great conversation starter when people find out that it's solar powered. So also for the existing vendor, it's a great add-on.
Okay. So you know that most of my audience is hot dog vendors or street vendors of some sort. This would be a great add-on for those people who may go, you know what, I'm going to put my daughter in this. It's going to be less expensive. My son-in-law just lost his job and I've been supporting him. I'm going to buy one. And they can start making some money. And you can, even though this is seasonal, you can make enough money in the good months to not work in the bad months.
Yeah. But I mean, it's also just a great add-on because you've got it there. And then you're telling people, you're educating them, letting them know, not only you're selling ice cream at your stand or your cart every day, but you're basically creating your customers by letting them know, hey, you know, we're green. We can do parties. We can do branding. So you're almost building your customer base out of your existing customers that your hot dog customers. I mean, it's a great way to build, you know, an additional business out of your current business. And like you said, a lot of these people that have lost jobs, things like that, everybody knows somebody that's been downsized or lost a job or had their job shipped overseas. You know, set up a deal with them. You know, I know a vendor down in, I won't use any names, but, you know, he's doing well, started with a cart now on a trailer, and he's got a friend who lost his job. And, you know, he's talking about putting his buddy in there. So, I mean, there's ways, things you can do, help out your family, help out a friend, or just expand your current business. I mean,
this can be a full-time income, and depending on how you want to do it, you could have two full-time incomes and never touch this.
Yeah.
You could put somebody to work on it who's going to make them a living, and you still profit off of it every month.
Yeah.
I love the concept. I like the fact that there's less risks with it. Now, obviously, you know, I don't want to poor mouth or bad mouth the hot dog business. It's brought me to the table and it saved my life, you know.
Yeah.
But I know that this is a viable opportunity and a viable business for anyone who can't, you know, has found restrictions too tight or has found that the money to get involved is too restrictive for their budget, or they couldn't do a certain thing they wanted to do or a certain product. This opens them up to an immediate business. They could get one of these, and you've got some the prototypes that you can go now with. They could buy one, be selling in a week, and actually making $500, $600, $700, $800, $1,200, $1,500 a week, depending on weather and locations, off of a bike, a bicycle.
Yeah.
It's phenomenal. I mean, think about that. How many of us go to college? You know, I spent almost 3 weeks in college, but how many of us go to college thinking we're going to get out and get a good job? A lot of people, that worked for our parents and their parents. It's not a guarantee anymore. There's attorneys out who aren't working as attorneys, who spent $200,000, $300,000 getting an education. And we've got ice cream vendors out there making $1,500 a week. And if you took it by the hour, they're making attorney pay $200 and $300, $400 an hour. Even if you made $50 an hour, who wouldn't take that? I'd take that all day long.
I mean, even if you did it part-time, it's still almost a full-time income. I mean, you could just work nights with the little leagues or your park and rec department, things like that. Or just doing a route in the evening, taking it out and running a certain number of streets. You know, so, I mean, it doesn't even have to be a full-time thing. It can be a part-time thing.
There's a lady just started in the hot dog business, and she called me this week, and she said, Ben, I'm just a little discouraged. I went out the first day, and it started raining before I even got set up, and I had to go home. And then she said, I went out the next day, and she go, and this was the next day. She calls me from the location, I assume, because she said, I'm out here, and this is my second day. And she said, I have, she goes, I've only sold 12 meals, and I've been here an hour. And I said, okay, well, how much are your meals? And she said, they're $5 like you teach. And I said, well, you know, I teach that's my number. Your number can be different. You never know.
Yeah.
Well, she said, I mean, depending on your cost of your foods and stuff. But she took my number, $5, did her two dogs, chips, and a drink meal. And I said, okay, so 5 times 12, according to my math, is 60. And I said, and so if you've paid the same as I pay, that's about 30% cost out of that 60. That's $18 out. That's $42 you made in the last hour. And she goes, I did? And I said, yeah. You made $42 profit in the last hour. Where can you go get a job for $42 an hour? And it's all our perception. She was looking at it as, I only did 12 meals. And I'm going, 12 meals is pretty good. At $42 an hour, and you're brand new.
Yeah.
So
it only gets better. I mean, my first day out, I think we did $49 in sales. But it doubled every day. And consistency is the name of the game. Once your customers get to know you're going to be there, whether you're running a route or you're going to be at a daily location, once they know they can depend on you, it just goes from there. It just keeps doubling and building up. And before you know it, you're busy all day and you're going to be selling out. So, you know, and selling out's not a bad thing.
Right.
You know, creating a demand. We talked about that on the last show. You know, I love doing that. That's why people like myself and like Corey Lawrence, man, I always tweet about a sellout because people hate to be left out.
Right.
And, you know,
it encourages them to come now, come early. Don't miss out.
Yeah, don't miss out. You want that elk dog, you know, you got to be here a little earlier next time, Ben. And, you know, you tell the guys at work, oh, man, we got to leave now. We got to take lunch early because he sells out early and they wind up showing up early.
I was going to talk on the radio show tonight a little bit about that, about this false notion that we, you get a customer or two that says, boy, you know, or not a customer, a nearby business, because this has happened just recently. And they tell you, oh, you should have been here Tuesday. Oh my gosh, there was so many people came here for you. And you go, okay, well, I'm going to be open Tuesday now. I'm going to work 7 days a week. And if that doesn't work, I'll do 8. You'll never please everybody at the same time, but I'm going to discuss that a little bit on the show tonight. You create a demand and they will come to you and they'll find you and they'll use you.
They'll seek you out. I mean, it's amazing, you know, when you create that sense of urgency,
right,
and limited availability.
Yeah. It's why all these companies do 72-hour sales, and they do even when they don't even have anything on sale. They'll go a weekend blast sale at JCPenney's, and you're going, all right. And it just creates a sense of urgency, but it doesn't – that's what you need to do with the food. So I love
The other thing you can do with the ice cream is like what I do with sausage, rotate every 2 weeks or every other week or something, you know.
Yeah.
Especially if you get yourself a freezer from your supplier, you know, this week the specials are this, this, and this. Next week it's this, that, and the other thing. So, you know, there's so many options.
Is there anything you want to add before we go so that that we didn't cover well?
I don't think so. I mean, we could talk for hours. I mean, you know that, both of us. I mean, it could just go on.
We can bore some people to tears.
Yeah, I mean, people have seen that on the show. You know, an hour show winds up being 3 hours. So, I can't, you know, the only thing I can say is, you know, if you have questions, call. It's a great add-on if you're already running a Ben's cart or you know, a truck,
anything.
A trailer. It's a great add-on. It's a great part-time business. It's a great full-time business. You know, again, you can start out part-time and go full-time. You know, you might be able to leave that cubicle You know, start out by doing weekends and evenings, and then eventually get yourself to the point you can run full time or get that money to buy that hot dog cart that you want.